Hey guys, so we are back again. So a lot of people were asking me, by the way, Dr. Bhuza, I think all of you know. So a lot of people, they were asking me, how does Dr. Bhuza know, I mean, he has so much of experience about the bikes and repairs and all that. There are some reasons, I think he can explain.
So one is I always do my own servicing on the Bhuza. So That's how I have the experience. Plus in 2012 to 14, I had my own garage. So I used to get a lot of my friends' bikes, which we used to service and take care of.
By own?
Yeah. So it was just me and another friend. So okay. Both of us used to run the garage. We used to service the bikes on our own.
Right.
So we used to do it for our friends.
So that is the reason he has got a lot of knowledge. And apart from that, he also does a lot of R&D. So yeah. Because of that, he knows. So today we are going to replace the brake pads of the Versys. We'll do the front side and in the video, we will show you only one side so that the video is short and crisp. So let's go ahead. Harish, so we are replacing the brake pads with the
yes.
EBC brake pad. I was said that EBC is a performance brake pad. It is any day better than the stock ones. Mm. So I'm going to use them. Little expensive though. It costs about 3000 rupees roughly per pad in India. So let's go ahead.
Sure. So the first thing that I would recommend is that you have a pair of gloves, because if your hands get dirty, it's difficult to wash and then you'll have a lot of stuff under your nails. And when you're eating food, it's going to taste bad. The next thing that we have that we are using is this one. This is an Align key set that we will need. And the third item that we'll be using is the toolkit. So we're using a skill toolkit. It's got everything that we need to remove the calipers and change them. Today we will be changing the brake pads on both the front calipers, but for the video we are just going to show you one side of it so that we just save time. And coming to brake pads, okay, so we have different type of brake pads. When I say different type, what I mean is that each brake pad has a different compound. So this is basically a pad which is there, the surface. So there are different types. One is organic, which is basically the standard brake pads that come on the bike. The next comes as semi-stintered, which means that it has metal particles with organic blended in. Then you have a stintered metal brake pad, which is this one that I'm holding. And then you have ceramic and carbon ceramic compound brake pads. I typically would suggest that to use a semi-stintered or a stintered, because they have better heat resistance. That means that the more frequent you use your brake, typically the brake loses its capacity to hold and stop, so the stopping power will reduce. But since stintered metal brake pads have a higher heat resistance, they will perform at a better level than the organic ones. The reason I don't recommend using a carbon or a carbon ceramic is, one, your rotors will start to wear off, because these rotors are not meant to work with the carbon and carbon ceramic brake pads. Second is that they are higher, the braking capacity starts at a slightly higher temperature than your organic and stintered. So in the initial period, you'll find the brakes spongy, but once they're up to operating temperature, you'll start that the bite is very nice and they'll stop very well. The disadvantage is that you will lose your rotors much sooner, because these rotors are not meant to work with those compounds, and you will not enjoy it because it's not a day-to-day usage, right? So those are the brake pads that you use on a track when you're going to do 20 laps, 30 laps, and you're going to race your bike, okay? Now, let's start removing the calipers, and then after that, we'll install the brake pad. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is take out the ABS sensor wire. I'm only doing it because it will be more convenient for me to, you know, take out the caliper that is there, okay? So I'm going to remove this. This is the ABS sensor. It's used for wheel speed sensing. It's a simple clip-on, so you can take it out, keep it here. So this is a 12 mm bolt that we need to take out. So I'm going to use this socket along with a connector so I get a little more length. The length will help me in turning this around in a very easy way. when doing it, just be careful. In my case, this slipped a little bit. I'm lucky that it's not, slipped the head of the nuts. But there's a risk that if that wears out, you may have to change the nut cuts there. Before I pull out these two bolts, I need to loosen this one, because this is the pin which holds the brake pads together. This is an 8mm socket to take it out. If you try to remove this after removing the caliper, it's going to be difficult. You'll need another person's help to hold this, because this will be quite tight for you. Okay, so I'm going to
loosen
it out. Loosen this right now. That's it. Done. I'll get it as loose as possible. I won't pull it out, but as much of the thread I can take out, I'm going to take it out. Next. Remember, you should not press the brake when it's in this, when you're taking it out, otherwise the pistons will pop out, and then pushing them in will be a big pain, because you'll have to bleed the brakes, then reset it, because air will go inside. I'll pull this out. So that's why I suggested to take this, because yeah, now it's easy, otherwise it gets stuck. The pin's out, it's under pressure, so it's going to pop out. But before that, what I'm going to do is that the pistons are popped out, if you see here. Okay, the pistons are popped out. If you look over here, I need to push them in, because when I put the new brake pad, the material is more over there, so it will not fit back in. So I'm going to push the pistons in.
For that, you'll need a screwdriver.
For that, there are. For that, typically I would suggest to have a spanner and then do it based on a spanner. Okay, so the brake pads, if you see, the pistons are popped out, you need to push them in. Okay, luckily this bike has a twin piston caliper. It's a monoblock caliper. That means it's completely carved out of one single block of metal. The next thing is that in the super bikes, you have four piston calipers. So you'll have two pistons this side, two pistons the other side, and oil goes in and pushes the pistons on both the sides. In this one, this brake pad is fixed. Only this brake pad is moving, so stop the bike. So the way to push it in is that, this is how I'm going to do it, using a spanner.
So it's better to use with the old pads.
It's better to do with the old pads.
Pushing the piston directly. Yeah.
And please do it on the brake pads. Don't touch the pistons, because if you put this and push the piston, there'll be marks that will form on the piston, and then oil will start to leak and your brake will fail.
Alright.
Okay.
So this is the best way.
The way to do it is between the old pads, keep them and push them out. Okay. So when you push it in, okay, so you can see that the gap has increased. So now this is sufficient enough. You can see the piston has moved inside. Gap is more. Now I'm going to take out this one completely. It's already come out. I just need to pull it out. So carefully pull it out. Yeah. Now you can see. If you find any oil leaking from any of these edges, that means your caliper seals are gone and the pistons are gone.
So new replacement.
So you'll have to replace the whole caliper or rebuild the caliper. Okay. In this case, your caliper is good. There's no oil leakage anywhere. Okay. This is a clip that comes. This clip is what keeps the brake pads apart. So when you brake it, the pistons push the brake pads together. And then when you release the brake, these clips act as spring over here and here. They act as spring and they'll push the brake pads back into the normal position. Otherwise, they will continuously be rubbing against your disc. Your disc will wear out. The brake pads will be too hot. And when you try to brake, they will not hold. Okay. So let's get this out. So these are the original Nissan brake pads. You can look at them. And these are stinted metal brake pads. So at this point in time, what you can do is that you can have a mug of water and you can just put a little bit of water and take out the excessive dirt that you see here. The bike was actually washed a few days ago and it's not been used, so our caliper is pretty clean. Now we'll just install this back. So this is the first brake pad that I'm putting in on that side. The next one is this side. So when you put it back, it should sit in this groove. Is it coming in the video? Right. So it should sit in this groove. So I have it placed on the groove. If you see, I've kept them together because it's easier for me to bolt it in when they're together. Now I'm just going to tighten it a little bit, not completely. So I'm just tightening it as much as it allows me to when it's in my hand. Okay, that's it. I've just moved it back into position so that there's a gap for the disc to sit.
Space.
Yeah. Enough space.
Directly.
See, it's gone in smoothly. So first thing, mount the bolts. At this point, I'm not going to fully tighten it, I'm just going to tighten it to a particular, that's it, there's no pressure on it, we just tighten to hold actually. Just tightened back to the same way it was when I took it out. Lot of people say to use torque wrench setting and all. So if you have a torque wrench and you can know the setting, you can put it. So yeah, it's going to be 8 m of torque for that. This one's going to be tightened a little bit. Just be sure you don't tighten too much, because if the sprocket slips, this the head will go away. Then you'll have a big tough time. Okay. So that's done. The next thing that I'll do is I'll be plugging back these two pipes. Once they two are done, I will put the ABS sensor back. Just tightening this. Again, this one, don't tighten it too much. Just a little bit, but at the same time, it should not come out.
Right. So this side is done.
Next thing is, don't take the bike and just go away for rides. Okay.
Before that,
remember you pulled the brake pads apart, right? Mm-hmm. So the piston's pushed in, it's not come back to its normal setting. So pump your brake, see how loose it is.
It's very loose.
Yeah, that's because all the fluid has come back up.
Okay, it has to go down again.
Yeah, so once you pump it, it's going to bring the brake pads together again. So now it's tight and it's working. So remember, these are brand new brake pads. You need to do something called as bedding in. Bedding in is for letting the first small surface to go away from the brake pad. So when you're using it, just be a bit cautious, that don't try to do sudden stopping, last minute braking and
hard.
All. Yeah, or you can do hard braking, but don't expect it to give you the same performance as a used brake pad, because it takes about 100 to 150 kilometers for it to bed in. The first 100 to 150 kilometers, if you need to brake, you know something is up front, start braking a little early, do early braking. Once you're set, you get the feel of the brakes, then you can start doing last minute braking or hard braking.
So guys, you just saw how to replace the brake pad. So we just did one side of the brake pad. That's what we are going to show you in this video. The other side will do it right away, but we are not going to show it again because it's going to make the video very long. So it was quite simple, just that you have to be careful with all these things. So Harish, thank you so much for helping me out in changing the brake pads, and also for the people, it is going to be very helpful. Next time, sometime else, we also would show you how to do the bleeding of the brakes.
We'll do the back brake pads, then we'll do a bleeding, because this is an ABS system, they're linked. So your bleeding will be more complex than doing on a normal bike.
Okay.
Maybe we'll show how to do a brake bleeding on an Indian bike first,
like an
FZ150 or a Phaser.
Right.
I can bring one of my...
I also have the Phaser.
And then after that, we will probably show how to do the bleeding on the ABS system. Because that's the basics.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So we can do that sometime.
Right. So thank you so much, Harish, again. Yeah. So I know a lot of people will be expecting us to do some videos again together.
Sure.
So we'll do that. So that's all about it, friends. Do let me know if you have any questions in the comment section. Either me or Harish, someone of us will answer them. And if you have not yet subscribed to our channels, you can subscribe. Harish's channel is Dr. Bhuza. So you can, I'll also share a link in the description. In the last video, actually, I forgot to add the link, but this time I'll add it. You can follow him. Even though he's not creating so many videos, because right at this moment, he's actually traveling a lot.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, friends. And you can also follow me on Instagram at BuluBiker and him at Dr. Bhuza. Oh, yeah, but
yes.
Chalo. Thank you.
Okay. See you.